faces our returning champion, Sandy Adelson, from New York, New York. Stand by to see Sandy play for a pair of jet skis, valued at $5,998. Today, on America's biggest bargain sale, we're offering a Cadillac, valued at $26,304 for $530. Cash and prizes worth over $100,000 for $750. Two of the incredible bargains on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim Perry.
Come on out. Thank you very much. Thank you. You're very kind. Thank you. Welcome to Sale of the Century. Let's welcome back our champion. She won the championship on the last show. This is Sandy Adelson. Hi, Sandy.
Hi.
Nice to see you again.
It's good to be back.
Isn't it nice to be there when they say, here is our champion? Isn't that great?
It's unbelievable.
Well, you did well. Now, you won with $70, and the jet skis that Jay was talking about cost here on Sale of the Century $175. So you are $105 away from the jet skis, and of course, you've got to keep on winning to add to your total. Are you ready to go?
I sure am.
All right, good luck. Here to introduce the challengers. She didn't have time to change. She was doing her laundry, so she just rushed out here anyway in some old around-the-house outfit. This is Summer Bartholomew. Just a casual hanging around the house outfit there. You are so dressy. Looks nice.
So are you.
Fantastic
suit.
Whom did you bring us?
This contestant is a Toastmaster, originally from Chattanooga, Tennessee. An enthusiastic welcome to Ernie Miller.
Hi there, Ernie.
And she mends broken hearts from San Francisco, California. A big hand to Susan Krikori.
Hello there, Susan. Why do my outfits not look as good as yours to me? I don't know. See you later,
I'll
Summer. Susan, let's get acquainted. You mend broken hearts.
I'm afraid it's not nearly as romantic as it sounds. I'm a cardiac nurse.
Oh, I see. So you work with, well, that's good work and doing a lot of good. Do you enjoy it?
Oh, very much.
That's nice. Nice to have you here with us. Ernie, you are a Toastmaster.
Right. When I came to California from Chattanooga, Tennessee, I figured I had to learn to say, or speak properly, and learn to say far instead of far.
Right. So you there's...
Now I pronounce far properly.
Okay, well, that's good. So this is an organization you belong to, I guess, right?
It's an organization.
I've heard of them.
Very well recommended to.
Absolutely. And
if I can learn to speak properly and say, pronounce far.
Okay.
Anybody can.
Then we're ready to get started. Good luck to all three of you, and I'll fire away the first question in just a moment. $20 starts all three players off. Player with the most money at the end of the show is a champion. Gets to go shopping. Let's start with this. Name the hit TV show which features the action-packed adventures of a pair of cops named Crockett and Tubbs. Susan.
Miami Vice.
You got it. $5 for the correct answer. Susan goes to 25. From the old proverb, where does charity begin? Sandy.
At home.
At home it is. First five for the champion. She's at 25. The brightest of all recurring comets appears every 75, Sandy?
Halley's Comet.
Every 75 years, Halley's Comet, you're the one, and Sandy goes into the lead by five. What comes in the following styles? V-neck, cardigan, pullover, Sandy?
Sweaters.
Sweaters it is, champion up to 35. What is the four-word motto of the United States? Ernie?
A pluribus unum.
Can we have to, no, we got... That's only three, our judge said. No, the four word. We needed the English, in God we trust. I'm awfully sorry about that. Ernie, it cost you five down to 15. And he pronounced it so well. It's time now for an instant bargain. Player in the lead can buy bargain merchandise. Sandy, you have a $10 lead over Susan. I remember on the last show you picked up some good things. You might like these.
Sandy, this instant bargain will be music to your ears. His and Her Portables, the latest in new wave sound. This lavender AM/FM stereo records and plays cassettes. And for him, this sleek high-tech black stereo also has a double cassette system. Both furnished by Sharp, and they're normally priced at $300. But today on Sale of the Century, they're yours for only $6.
$300 for the His and Her stereos. Very nice.
My husband's a musician, and he absolutely adores having that kind of stuff around the house.
Well, that's, yeah, because you can have a different room. That is kind of handy to have them in different places. And if he's a musician, what a nice... We wouldn't even tell him. You can put them away as a present for him.
Okay.
Sandy, you've got a $10 lead. Yeah. If you buy the $300 worth of stereos, your lead would be cut to $4, but you still have the lead. I remember on the last show that all I had to do to get her to buy was to say,
doing it again.
I'll throw $200 in cash in with it, $500 bargain, you still have the lead. Going once, going twice, she's going to buy. Enjoy the stereos, enjoy the 210. $500 bargain for just $6. We knock it off your score. You're still in the lead. $4 over Susan. Back with us. Name the comic who used to end his TV show with a line, "Say goodnight, Gracie." Sandy?
George Burns.
George Burns it is. Sandy gets 5 of the 6 right back. Name the city which in 1816 succeeded Chillicothe as the capital of Ohio. Ernie?
Columbus.
Columbus it is. Ernie back to the $20 mark. Yes, indeed. And the Ernie Miller fan club has heard from. In the 70s, Dr. David Rubin attempted to tell you everything you always want, Susan?
That you wanted to know about sex, but were afraid to ask.
Yes, it sounds like you're ready. You got it all. Yes, and Susan goes to 30. It is time now for the Fame Game. We're playing for control of the Fame Game board and a lot of information about a famous person. I am an actor born in Boston in 1931. I was making a living acting and teaching when I was interviewed for an unusual role in an upcoming TV series. Remember, this is an actor. The show and my role intrigued me. I played the offspring of an Earth woman and a man from the planet Vulcan. I was made up. Sandy.
Leonard Nimoy.
You are right, yes. We didn't want Mr. Spock. We wanted Leonard Nimoy, the actor. Sandy, you've got control of the board now. There is a $10 money card Summer will show you.
Find the number 8.
All right, prize is behind the other 8. The lights are flashing. We lock them into your buzzer. Good luck, Sandy. You can stop that light whenever you want to.
Come on, number 8.
We stopped it up in the corner with number 3. We have this.
Cutlery. Cutco's complete 18-piece cutlery set featuring patented wedge lock handles, exclusive Double D grind cutting edge. Quality American craftsmanship furnished by Outcast Cutlery.
Very fancy cutlery. $578 worth. Yours to keep no matter how you finish in the game. And we will be back to the game right after we take time out for this. Please watch. Champion in the lead, but it's not a big one. Sandy at 34, Susan at 30, Ernie at 20. We're back with us for 5. You're all dressed up. What's that device attached to your fob? Sandy?
A watch.
A watch is exactly what it is, Sandy, to 39. What is the name of the musical game I'm playing? Jim, Jim, Bo, Bim, Banana, Fana, Sandy?
The name game.
Yiffy, Fi, Fo, Fun, Jim. That's the name game. You're right, Sandy, over the $40 mark. What's the name of the paper model used as a guide in making clothes? Sandy.
A pattern.
Pattern it is. The champion's starting to make a move. She's up to 49. Name the large, yellowish-white, carnivorous bear of the far north. Ernie.
Polar bear.
Polar bear it is. Ernie to 35. Yes. But again, an instant bargain. And Sandy, you've stretched that lead out a bit. You've got yourself a $19 lead, and we've got something you might be interested in.
Sandy, here are some tasty additions for your kitchen. First, this handsome, solid maple butcher block table and cutting board. The knife holder, wine rack, and easy roll casters may make entertaining more convenient and elegant. From Great Buildings Incorporated. Plus, beautiful La Cuisine cookware. Porcelain enamel on steel with solid brass handles and knobs. Furnished by Toll Silver Company. This kitchen pair is normally priced at $599. But today on sale of the century, yours for only $11.
Very nice things, yes. And even a knife holder to go with all the knives that you just got.
Does the chef have to come with it?
No, we absolutely promise he will not. $599 worth of great kitchen goodies for $11. You would still have an $8 lead. And I'll say it again, Sandy. $200 in cash to go with it. A $799 bargain. You still have an $8 lead going once. Going twice. Yes, indeed. $200 is the way to hurt Summerfest. Absolutely. Good job. And a nice buy again. And it cost you just $11. We knock it off your score. Still an $8 lead over Susan. Susan was saying, give her money. A popular form of punishment in colonial days was to administer a coating of tar. And Ernie.
Feathers.
Feathers it is. And Ernie ties Susan for second place. Very close. In what Korean city will the 1988 Olympic Games be held? Sandy.
Seoul.
Seoul is right, and Sandy again over the $40 mark. What color appears in the name of the mountains surrounding Atlanta, Georgia? Susan.
The Blue Mountains.
Blue, Blue Ridge Mountains. You're exactly right, Susan, to 35. What part of your body would a doctor examine through an otoscope? Sandy.
Your ears.
Your ears, yes, eardrum to be specific. The ears acceptable. Sandy, back to that $48. What sport do you play on a gridiron? Sandy.
Football.
Football it is. Sounds like a football fan. Sandy, over the $50 mark. Talking about football, you know, you think of the size of some of those pro football players. I love a man who knows himself, a big, giant football player for, I think it was the Atlanta Falcons, put a sign on his front, the front of his house, and it said, "Forget the dog, beware of the owner." We will be right back. Well, the championships in buying still stretched it out a little bit. Sandy at 53, Susan at 35, Ernie at 30. And again, the fame game, we're going to add a $15 money card on the board. You'll have two of them to shoot for with a famous thing. I am a musical instrument invented by Friedrich Boschmann in 1822. 30 years later, Bhutan added a keyboard to me, but the principle was known to the Chinese centuries before. I'm a reed-like instrument worn on straps around the shoulders. Susan.
An accordion.
Accordion is exactly what it is. Yeah, just way back, 1822. Susan, you've got control of the board this time. Where's the $15 money card?
It's behind the number 6.
So, 2 out of the 8 left have money cards. We lock it into your buzzer, Susan. Good luck. Stock that light whenever you want to.
Come on, 6!
Miss the money cards. I hope we have a nice prize for you.
It's a typewriter. The Silvereed EXT42 fully electronic compact daisy wheel typewriter. Practical enough for the home, durable enough for the office. Furnished by Silvereed.
That is a nice prize. $500 typewriter is yours to keep. And you can take that no matter how you finish in the game. And you're still in it right now with Sandy at 53, Susan at 35, and Ernie at 30. Back with this. An imaginative game played these days by young and old alike is known as, Susan?
Trivial Pursuit.
Oh, I bet if you had heard me say dungeons, you would have said dragons. Quick buzzer cost you 5. Sorry about that. What four-letter word means a large bound bundle, such as cotton or hay? Sandy.
Bale.
Bale is what it is. Sandy to 58. Phoebe Wallingford and Erica Kane. Susan?
All my children.
I get the feeling you watch that soap opera. You're right. Susan goes to 35. But it is time for an instant bargain now. And Sandy, again, you stretch your lead out a little bit. It's up. Oh, this is very unusual.
Sandy, if you like to horse around, you'll love Woods of America's Chief Executive Rocking Horse. Over 5 feet tall, handcrafted of hard pine, complete with real leather saddle, stirrups, bridle, mane, and tail. Furnished by Woods of America, and it's normally priced at $1,200. But today on sale of this entry, it's yours for only $15.
Wow.
That's
you got to admit, it doesn't take much to entertain our friend Karen here. You can have this very unusual item, $1,200, $15. You'd still have an $8 lead. And I'll say it again, I've been on a roll with Sandy, $200 in cash to go with it. You still have an $8 lead. Going once, going twice. No sale. Well, she didn't see herself riding a wooden hobby horse. I wonder why. We'll be right back. Champion Sandy Allison, she has the lead. Looking at those his and her jet skis, she's at 58. Susan in second place at 35. And Ernie, who keeps getting beaten at the buzzer during the commercial, Ernie said to me, "Is there a handicap division here?" Ernie's at 30. Back to this. In which nation on Asia's subcontinent will you find the cities of Hyderabad and Madras? Ernie.
India.
You beat him to the buzzer that time, and you're right. Ernie goes to Susan, tied at 35. To the Romans, Venus was the goddess of love. What did the Greeks call her? Ernie?
Aphrodite.
Yes, indeed. 2 in a row for Ernie. He doesn't need any handicap. He's up to 40. What dashing fictional hero was introduced to filmgoers in the 1962 movie Dr. No? Sandy.
James Bond.
James Bond, 007. And Sandy over the $60 mark. Yay. Third and final crack of the fame game now, players. We're looking for a famous thing. I am a river that irrigates more than 10 million acres of land. My valley and delta rank among the world's fertile farming areas. Susan.
The Nile.
With limited information, you are right. It is the Nile, yes. Well, first of all, we'll show you the $25 money card.
It's behind the number 4.
I need that
25. 3 out of the 7 money cards locked into your buzzer, Susan. Good luck.
Come on, number 4.
Wow. It's the $25 money card. We add that to Susan's score, and she goes up to $60 less than a question away from Sandy. We finish up the game now with a speed round. 60 seconds on the clock, please. But it is still the champion in the lead at 63. Susan at 60. Ernie not out about a 40 because I've got a lot of questions as we start the speed round. Now, in what U.S. state would you find the Grand Canyon? Sandy.
Colorado.
Wrong. What is the second letter of the Greek alphabet? Sandy.
Theta.
Right. Who was the partner of comedian Bud Abbott? Sandy.
Lou Costello.
Right. In which field of the arts was Franz Kafka famous?
Time. Name the only U.S. president elected for more than two terms. Ernie.
Franklin Roosevelt.
Right. What fluid comes in varieties such as A, B, A, B? Susan.
Blood.
Right. Name the legendary lumberjack who had a big blue ox, Sandy.
Paul Bunyan.
Right. According to the popular song title, what city does Randy Newman love? Susan.
L.A.
Right. The secret police of what country are called the KGB? Sandy.
Russia.
Right. According to the Old Testament, who led the Israelites out of Egypt? Ernie.
Moses.
Right. Bogota is the capital of what South America? Sandy.
Brazil.
Wrong. What country was defeated by the United States in the War of 1812? Susan.
Spain.
Wrong. In Shakespeare, what was Juliet's family name? Susan.
Time.
On what kind of time is up? And with those misses, Sandy comes out on top. Susan had a chance to overtake her and missed the last couple of questions. Back to the champion in just a moment. First of all, Juliet's family name, it had to be one of the two, Capulet. And in the War of 1812, the U.S. defeated Great Britain. And Bogota is the capital of Colombia. Franz Kafka was a writer, prose, literature, anything like that. The Grand Canyon is found in Arizona. Got to say goodbye to Susan and Ernie. Well, Susan, you got a beautiful typewriter with the cash in front of you, $560, and you really pushed the champion for a while there. And as a newlywed, just a couple of weeks wed, we wish you many years of happiness.
Thank you.
And Ernie, a great sense of humor. Got the cash in front of you. Thank you for joining us. Toastmasters never turn their back. Ernie, don't do that. Sandy, however, is going shopping with me. Come on, shopping, Sandy. Well, yes, she missed those last two, and that cost her.
I didn't believe it.
And you stand here now with $143, enough money to buy this. That's the brass desk and mirror that you've already seen. You fell a little short of the his and her jet skis. You got $143. You need $32 more and another win, and you could have these.
Make waves with that special someone with these his and her jet skis. Maybe the ultimate water toys. With jumping the wake, racing, or just plain showing off. Furnished by Foothill Yamaha Kawasaki. Normally priced at $5,998. Yours on sale of the century for only $175.
They are a lot of fun. $175, you've got $143, so you'd have to keep winning just $32 more. Next thing up the line are gold coins, $260. You've seen those. This is something you haven't seen. Get to $340. Instead of that transportation on the water, you could have this.
Be the captain of your own ship with this beautiful speedboat. A sleek family runabout that's great for skiing or for relaxing cruises on the water. With lay-down seats for optimum sunning. Furnished by Ken's Boat Center. Normally priced at $11,850. Yours on sale of the century for only $340.
Wow! It looks something like the two people I saw on the jet skis, too. That's amazing. That's very nice. But I remember on the last show, we talked about one thing. She said she wanted to get the $445 because this is what she really wants.
Grab your lucky four-leaf clover because you're off on a trip to Ireland. We'll fly you and a friend from Los Angeles for 15 fabulous days on the Emerald Isle. Contrast the proud past with today's Ireland. Enjoy the green countryside, the friendly people and their legends, and maybe even a leprechaun. Normally priced at $15,000, yours on sale of the century for only $445.
Well, last week you turned him into a frog. Now he's a leopard. If you get to $750, you will get every prize we've got on the stage. And this...
a cash jackpot of $75,000.
And that is a total of $146,075 in cash and prizes that could be yours. But Sandy, right now, you've got $143. It easily buys you the brass desk and the mirror. The next thing up the line is $32 more away. You need $175. So another win, you'd, I'm sure, have more than $32. And you could have the his and her jet skis. You think about it for a moment, and we'll get your decision right after this.
Back with Sandy Adelson, who has picked up a lot of good things and a lot of cash along the way. Now the question is she going to leave us with the brass desk and mirror, or take the chance that you can continue to win $32 more away from his and her jet skis? Sandy, what's it going to be?
I'm having such a terrific time. I'm going to come back.
I thought she was. We'll put her money in the bank. We'll have another $1,000 for that cash jackpot. $76,000. Two new challenges next time on Sale of the Century. Bye for now.
Bye-bye.
I kind of thought that was what the decision was going to be.
Some of our departing contestants will receive...
For years, I've grown beautiful plants like these the easy way, with Oxygen Plus plant food. Use Oxygen Plus. It breathes life into your plants.
Prices are manufacturer's suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording. Sale of the Century stars Jim Perry. This is Jay Stewart speaking. Century is a Red Strandy production.